Yes, yes, it's the intro.
They don't know what they're in for. It be coming like this on the intro. What they here for? If they want the heat, you know who to send for your info. Buy my money like Venmo. This music don't work out. I know how to get it from my ends low. How you feel though? Cause, hey, they can't rock with us. Galaxy ain't no stopping us. They ain't trying to steal my style. I'm feeling like I just shopping. Can't trust him cause he number. Cause we worried about getting figures. I'm a ain't father figures. Just know my quick to pop it.
Damn, it's the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, this is the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, it's the intro? Yes, it's the intro. Damn, this is the intro? Yes, it's the intro.
I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in
I'm
the game.
I'm whipping that truck out with messed up suspension. I drove it so fast that I blew out the engine. I kept it 2 mil ever since the beginning. I play offensive D, I might switch my position. Lil' mama was thirsty, so I had to quench. I'ma drive real fast, cause you know I shoot quick. Just like Travis Kelsey, I be having emotions. Just like a lamb, I ain't know I'm exploding. My heart cold, bad, I ain't got emotions. I'm going hard, yeah, you know I'm devoted. We running streets, yeah, you know we control it. She love the kids, she be busting it open. I'm quarterbacking like I'm Kyler Murray. Trying to win, I'm up at practice early. Going crazy, I just run the jersey. It's the first half, and we and drop 30.
We just up to scoring them, boy,
huh? I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
Money on my mind, head in the game. It's like I scored again, diamonds on them dance. I can hear the music playing with them bands. Crowd going wild, dived in the fans. I'm locking in on a mission, I'm telling my vision. You young as she get like me. I got your shorty, she with me. I gave her a jersey, I told her to join my team. It's best you go where it's safe. You know how I play, I get to a sack like Frank. You can teach money to fly, I turn it up hop. I catch it and go to the bank. It's crazy, I'm used to the lights, I'm shining so bright. It's visor to cover my face. You see me working and working, I'm getting it done. As soon they be feeding me grapes.
I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head
they
in the game.
They screaming my name when I walk in the building. Yellow diamonds on me like I play for the Steelers. I'm in the field, yup, just like a Steeler. Oh, this your girl, my bad, had the Steeler. I hop on the beat and I float like a real. I caught a TD, yeah, right across the middle. I'm speaking facts, boy, you telling riddles. Can't hang with the gang, so we had to sit them. We're down. I'm in L.A. riding around and around. My dog just called, say he finna touch down. When I call a play, do I hear a sound? Hold on, hold on, hold on. Money caller right.
Southern California has a new modern home for NFL football, and it is this place. Wondrous SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood. Today we've got an interesting Week 11 matchup on tap between the New York Jets and the Los Angeles Chargers. Season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. At their own 20-yard line. Cooper will look to throw it. That one taken in by T. Higgins.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Best has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. They'll run. This is Jonathan Taylor. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. The Chargers at 6-3 on the year. Charles, they were losers last time out. What do you think they need to do differently here?
Well, I don't think it needs to be as drastic as burning up last week's game tape or not watching it, but the attitude has to be what's done is done. Let's move on. Put that one behind them, galvanize themselves, and go forward and get a win in this one.
Back to Taylor on first down. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes it's his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
On second down, it's Taylor. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring out the third down. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
The Jets will bring in a nickel set here as they try to stop this third down. Here's Cooper. And that is incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. That'll go as a punt of 42, 7 on the return. And the Jets will take over first and 10. Incomplete.
Textbook coverage right there. Played the ball, never lost sight of where it was headed, and stayed in perfect position to make a play on it. Able to keep the receiver and the quarterback in his sight lines.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Carry for the Iowa State man, Breece Hall. And he powers his way up past the 30. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off. Pretty decent game.
First before he's taken down at the 36. They get 5 out of that one, and it moves the chains.
I definitely like the play call. You don't expect it on 3rd and 5, 3rd and 6, do you? You expect a pass play. Had a little courage there to call the run, and boy, they were successful.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. Looking left side of him, he's got a man. That's Holmes. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. That's good for a Jet first down, a gain of 13. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. Wilson gets rid of it quickly, and he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
Oh, I see you nodding your head along with me, partner, because it's pretty obvious what they're trying to do there on the drag route. With his speed, you're hoping he can turn the corner and maybe take this to the house. But that was excellent work defensively to make sure once he caught it, he wasn't going anywhere.
And all the way in, touchdown, New York.
Well, earlier in the week when they had their scouting report meeting, this was the explosiveness that they talked about trying to contain. They were concerned about it all week. Yet he still did it to them. Wonder how that's going to carry over the rest of the game.
Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and he'll take over at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10. This one is stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. Second down, another run with Taylor. And to the 42-yard line here, and brought down there. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
Oh, he'll let one go deep for Higgins. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Well, how about the challenge we're seeing here in this game early? Man coverage against some fleet receivers. That time, the defense won.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Now Cooper looks to throw. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
This offensive line has struggled. In fact, when we sat down with the coach, he said it's been in tatters lately. They allowed 6 sacks in their last game. Just gave up another one right there.
In tatters, so it sounds a little bit like this right now.
Exactly. It's like that paper being ripped. And right now, they've got to find a way to get it back together.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. Operating from the gun, Cooper. That's going to be... And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. A lot of talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it, and not realizing that danger lurks while you're doing so. And there's your end result right there.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Now it's Wilson. He'll get this one complete to Atwell. And they're going to get this up to midfield. They'll run with Hall. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Chargers nothing.
Lock it.
slot man moves right. On first down, right back to Hall. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 69 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
On first and 10, it's Hall. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Play action. It's Wilson. Steps away to his left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Eugene and Wilson got the sack there.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense. It kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
Third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to sling this deep downfield. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Derwin James with a pick. And the Chargers are going to take possession here at their own 3-yard line. They're trying to resurrect his confidence. Last week was a disaster. 5 interceptions in that loss and another pick there.
I played with a quarterback like this before, and he had a tough game. And the head coach said, I'll take him. I'll fix him. The very next game, he started out the exact same way. The head coach turned to the offense coordinator and said, he's yours from now on. Someone has to take responsibility and work with him and try and get him settled.
So no gain on the play. They'll decline the penalty to not give him the down back.
And were you thinking to yourself that maybe they would take the yardage there?
Yeah,
because
possibly.
I was. I definitely was. But as you noted, maybe they're just looking at the downs chart and saying, okay, we're comfortable where we are.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Running straight ahead, Taylor. And he's going to take this up past the 10 to about the 11. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And this is going to depend on his spot, but I believe he might be a few inches short. They'll run for it. It's Taylor. Oh, and I think he went backward. He did. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Well, it's gutsy to go for it in the red zone. The problem there is they were in their own red zone. Why in the world did they do that?
They must have thought they had the exact play call that they needed to go a big way. And I'm still not even buying that. I'm reaching.
You're searching.
Actually reaching, but I do know this. On the other side of the field, that coaching staff is screaming at their defense. If you don't handle this one right here, this is a great opportunity for us. Take it away, guys. And they did.
And now excellent field position. Touchdown! A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Jets are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that'll make the score 14-0. 14 Chargers, nothing. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Quinnen Williams able to record his fifth sack of the season.
Well, you're already up a couple of scores here in the first half defensively, and Charles, they just seem to be playing really free on that side of the football.
I love the observation, because with that type of a lead, they feel like they can take a few more chances and be even more aggressive, and it's been paying off for them so far this game.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Taken from just outside the 30. A pretty good punt, but a nice 13-yard return. And the Jets will take over. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they are a game under 500 now following the loss a week ago. And this is a team, Charles, that just has not been able to string victories together.
Yeah, they certainly come the wrong way, aren't they? Because it looked like they were things pointing in the right direction, but now they've lost two straight. And that means this game is vital, extremely important, because if they fall two games below 500, the road back into playoff contention, awfully difficult.
And a lane slow and materializing there as he'll get maybe a yard up to the 45.
The Jets on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. They go play action with Wilson. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Ojina Nwosu in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2-minute warning. Now the Jets send on Braden Mann to punt. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Fielded at the 20. Call that a 41-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. Charger drive about to get going. And 3 and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching. The ball is free. Taylor lost it. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble.
Even though he recovered his own. And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. From the 31, Cooper. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Hall. And the Jets are going to take possession of the football.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure.
They run it with Hall. And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line. 89 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
Now this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Hall again.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the five-yard line. Steps away. This is caught. Touchdown, Jets. Breece Hall. As the first half is winding down, and the Jets would extend their lead here just before halftime. The call is to go for one and kick the extra point. And it is now 21 to nothing.
Makes the score Jets 21, Chargers nothing.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Off the play fake, Cooper. He's going to let this one go deep. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Sauce Gardner picks it off. And the Jets are going to take possession of the football. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
After the interception, here's Wilson. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through, and that will do it for this first half. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. And the Jets set to receive this third quarter kickoff, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in the second half. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. Come on, Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Second half starts with a run by Hall. They find some open field here. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield.
Outside handoff to the right side. If you're a running back, you love getting the ball early so you have vision to see what's happening in front of you.
Right tackle likes that call. Big play for him. But don't forget about the guys you always tell me on the backside sealing off.
When they talk about cutoff blocks, making sure no one can leak from the backside that can run a play down.
Yeah, nobody leaked. Big play. He'll get it up near midfield to the 49 before being taken down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
Now Wilson. This caught. Reception by Holmes. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And a third down and six to go.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. In motion left here, one of their tight ends. On third down, here's Hall. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Fourth down, here's Wilson. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out. And this defense will take over right at midfield. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Open man is Myers. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football, and right now I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Up the middle, here's Taylor. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Back to throw, Cooper. Throw left side complete. That's Porter. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line.
One of the advantages of our defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts because he definitely needs some assistance.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Looking to throw, Cooper. And that is going to be incomplete as he led him a bit too much.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Operating from the gun, Cooper. And that incomplete nearly intercepted. And remember, he had his hands on one earlier, had one pick. Could have been his second, but instead it's fourth down.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already. And it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
And his kick here is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
After the made field goal, here's McLaughlin back out there to kick it away. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and he'll take over at the 25. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And a drive that stalled out last time. Went for it on fourth, didn't get it. How does that translate here? I would imagine momentum's with the defense.
Definitely with the defense, because anytime anyone goes for it on fourth down, that's telling you as a defense that you can't stop us. We don't think that you can. And when you actually do, that may put a little dent in the confidence of the offense the next time they hit the field.
Yeah, we'll see if they can bring that pride the offense this go around.
Well, you know me, whether you need it or not, I'm going to give a little unsolicited advice. Just drop downfield out of the pocket only if you're absolutely sure. Otherwise, use your running ability and try to get those yards a safer way.
Third and long, it's Wilson. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. He's got this almost to the 40 before going out. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
He came through well with a nice pass breakup there. Fortunate that he was on the spot. He's the only guy left to prevent the first down.
Third quarter now from SoFi Stadium. Here's a second and 10. On second down, a run with Hall. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. On third down, Wilson. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Oh, want to give up the middle. And they'll get this just to the 47, one-yard gain.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
That could have been a huge play, but give the defender credit. Stayed calm, stayed collected, and kept himself in a position to make a play on the ball without a penalty.
And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. Well, for almost 8 years, 64 stood as the NFL record for the longest field goal. That has since been eclipsed. It's now 66, but still 64-yarder, pretty impressive, CD.
Absolutely agree with that, because if you drill a 60-yarder in an NFL game, you've got a lot to be proud of, record or no record. And only a handful of guys can even attempt it. Excellent job there, putting that one through the pipes.
The Charger drive about to get going. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles, if they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. And the Jets are going to take possession of the football. Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season.
He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Running left, it's Hall. And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. A familiar refrain. A turnover leads to a touchdown, and that lead grows even wider now here in this third quarter.
Yeah, partner, I'd say there are a lot of grins breaking out on that sideline because, let's face it, they came in thinking they were in for a real fight in this game, but this one's been about as one-sided as we've seen in a while. In addition, if you're a backup, time to start stretching and loosening up. You may get some playing time in this one.
The Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. At their own 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here and maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. They run once more with Taylor. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. To the right side, this is Taylor. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. This run defense has been pretty stout all game long. Now you're here in the fourth quarter. Rely more on the passing attack.
I don't think you have any choice, and I don't think you have to dress it up at all either. Throughout the first three quarters, you're still trying to convince the defense that you may run the football. That's out the window right now. Protect, let your quarterback operate, and try and find some targets in the open field downfield.
Now, meanwhile, here's a 2nd down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
And that's another play that's painting the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Now the throw on 3rd down, knocked away and incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The 4th down play doesn't work for the Chargers, and the Jets are going to get the football here in great field position. My goodness. Picked off by Nasir Adderley. And he brings this one back. It's a pick 6 and a Charger TD. The
this game still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell, just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football, because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they didn't get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. We find ourselves here in the midst of a one-sided affair. A lot of fill time down the stretch, Mr. Davis.
So we could talk about food, because that is something that you and I
we
enjoy our time at the table. So maybe the best steakhouses in the city, but in all seriousness, the performances that we've seen this year, we've seen a bunch of great ones, and it's going to be hard to parse who's going to win the MVP.
Yeah, it really is.
Is it going to be a runner? Is it going to be a thrower? Can a defender finally win it this season? Those are the things that we could probably discuss.
And collectively, this is about as dominant of a performance as you could have hoped for on both sides of the football.
You might have to put in number one for what we've seen this season. Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. Chalk that up as a four-yard loss, and now it's third down. Off the play fake, here's Wilson. He'll buy some time right. And he'll find Hall. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. That one good for only six, and it leaves him with a fourth down. Here's the Jets punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. This is taken around the 12. It'll be a net of 40 yards following a punt of 44. And the Chargers will be backed up deep to begin their drive as they take over first and 10. The Charger drive about to get going.
Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yardage, because I was thinking to myself, we've seen a lot of NFL games, and we've seen our share of lopsided contests, but in almost all of them, both offenses have put up at least 200 yards in a game, but not in this one. This has been a display of offense that, frankly, I think the two of us have watched from behind our hands, trying to spread our fingers wide enough to actually see the result.
And this is going to fall to the ground incomplete. That very nearly their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down. On second and 10, Cooper. That's caught by Myers. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 39. Cooper will look to throw it. And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. And the throw didn't give him a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up second down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
To throw once more on second and 10. Cooper over the middle, complete. That's Myers. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 16. 23 yards the pickup there.
With this game well in hand, perhaps we are seeing the coverage lighten up a little bit as they got burned there a bit for a first down.
Well, we certainly know the coach isn't happy along the sideline.
Touchdown, Chargers! Chargers are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. Well, Charles, he's still a young signal caller in this league, second year in the NFL. And I don't know if last year as a rookie if he would have worked through his progressions like he did on that touchdown pass.
I think you're right about that. We're seeing him grow up right in front of our eyes because when he went to his primary read, he recognized that they were all over that. So he continued to survey the field, picked up another target, delivered a pass exactly where it needed to be. A very mature play for the second-year quarterback.
And the Jets have got it. Now they're down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 35-yard line. They'll go again with Hall. And he'll get two or three out of that one as that is going to take us to the two-minute warning.
Credit the tackle there to Uchenna Nwosu. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
The toss, it's Hall.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Now it's Wilson.
And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far.
And the Chargers are going to take possession of the football. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has deployed in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Here's Cooper. And that's complete to the right side. It's Marshall. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. Another nice gain. 16 yards there and a first down again.
If he's their best threat on offense, use your number one cover guy on defense. It doesn't matter about size.
They have had him locked up. That just his first catch of the game. Big reason why they're down. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. To throw again. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Well, it certainly appears to me that the defensive guys are starting to look a little bit tired while he still has some fresh legs. Not the biggest gain we've seen on a scramble, but still some positive yardage on a play that initially looked like a sure win for the defense.
Now Cooper gonna throw on third and goal. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
And once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. As as expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. They get the completion but cannot push forward into the end zone. And that will force a turnover on downs. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they look to finish strong in this fourth quarter. And this is a unit that certainly has turned things around from a week ago. Just a much more productive.